special form. I want to give all honors and praises and glory. Belongs to my Lord and Savior. His name is Yahweh Bahasham, Yahawashai Bahasham, Wahavakar Kadash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and His Son's name is Yahawashai, in whom we reverence and honor to the elder apostles of Great Millstone that taught me this truth. And those of you that have in the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved in these last days. This ain't going to be a long lesson. It's going to be a quickie. You can only grow if you're not comfortable. If you're comfortable, then there's the room for growth. Because when you're comfortable, you think, well, I already have it. Nope. I'm still learning them things in this truth. Every single day there's something I'm learning. Every single day. Whether it be small or a great thing. Okay? And comfortability leads to complacency. Complacency leads to what? A lack of growth. Stagnation. Okay? And you have to want to grow in this truth. This for me also. You have to want to grow. You can never get to the point where it's enough. Okay? Because we could always be more. Always learn more. Wisdom never fades. So let's start at John 7:38 and begin with verse 36. He that believeth on me, as the scripture have said, this is one of my favorite scriptures as well. So you've got to believe on Yahusha as the scriptures have said. Not your own prediction, not your own way. Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. The reason why that can live in water, which is the word, which is abundant, the reason why a man will have the capacity to gush out these rivers of living water, because he believes in Yahweh Yahushua, as the scriptures have said. Okay? And stagnant water, what does it promote? It promotes mosquitoes. It promotes dirt. You ever looked at a stagnant pond? Because it doesn't have no water flow, it doesn't have that flow. Okay? And if you've studied fish, if any of you have ever bought any fish, okay, as pets, okay, to have around, okay, if you ever bought a fish and you put it into a tank and that tank's too small, it would die within, what, two years, 1 year? But if you put it in an open space, that fish is going to grow. And I've seen it personally because I've got a couple. Okay, I won't tell you too much of my business, but you're going to grow. And that's what this truth is about. Growth. Constantly growing, constantly learning. Be willing to learn every single day. So I want to quickly go to Sirach 34 and 11. When I traveled, I saw many things. Jake only knows about their local neighborhoods, their local hoods, their local borough, their local council estate. They don't know anything outside of that. Esau will tell you it's a small world. No, it's not. He's telling you that while he's traveling the world, learning new things, seeing how different realms operate. So when you travel, you're also supposed to learn new things, see different things, experience different things. People are going to compensate. People are going to ask you questions. And I saw many things, and I understood more than I can express. So with you traveling, you're gaining new things, you're learning about yourself, communicating, because you may be a brother that may say, well, what do they call it? You're an introvert. Well, in this trip, you're forced to be an extrovert. You're forced to be an extrovert. You're forced to, because you have to communicate. People are going to ask questions. That's part of growing. You're forced to travel, because the scriptures do say we have no certain dwelling place. We are as pilgrims. You can't really grow. You're going to learn stuff. I learn stuff being in the confines of your own surroundings, your little bubble, but you need to come out of that bubble. You need to come out of that shell. That's the only way you're really, really going to grow. And because you have a strategy of doing that, he can work with you. He can still work with you. Don't get it twisted. You, in your own borough, your own city. But outside of that, you traveling, you gaining experience, and you wanting. You have to put it into practice. See, there's one level of that knowledge. The book knowledge, you're sounding good. You're sounding deep. But when you actually have to put these things in practice, there's a whole other level. And that's what I'm learning about this truth. I'm learning a lot about myself. How to communicate better. Sometimes I've lacked in that. Better communication. Okay. How to deal with people. All these different things. Okay. And I saw many things. And you see a lot when you're teaching, especially on the highways and byways. And not just the highways and byways, in everyday life. You can't learn as much when you're in the confines of what? The walls of your own house, or your flat, or wherever you may be living, or your hostel. I understand more than I can express, or more was understood than he could express, because he saw many things. I was in often times of danger of death. Now, I'm not going to tell you everything I've been through, because it's not about me, but you're going to see things. When you're out there, you're going to see things. And not everything I see, I mention. Because certain things are just for me and me only. It's not for every for the whole world to know. Yet I was delivered because of these things. The spirit of the Lord, the spirit of those that fear the Lord shall live. Okay? And for their hope is in him that saveth them. Whosoever feared the Lord shall have shall not fear nor be afraid, for he is his hope. And part of not wanting to venture out in terms of gaining new understanding and wisdom, and even outside the confines of where you grew up, is through fear, the fear of Esau. See, when you have the fear of the Lord, you can go anywhere, anywhere, and not have to worry about anything. I'm not talking about in a silly way. I'm not saying all that now. You put yourself in a way of danger. No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying you want to be tested. Okay? So when you pray for faith, you want to be tested. A lot of men, they put their foot in the puddle, and it's too hot. And they dip their fat foot right out. Both feet in. You ready? Trust your house, you're going to take them steps. Let's go to first difference. You're going to cut off things. Okay. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 3 and 3. We are yet carnal. For whereas there is among you envying and strife. So you definitely know that's a carnal attribute. Envy and strife. Okay? Rivalry, jealousy. And you shouldn't have that. That shouldn't be in the truth. Okay? And strife. So that's how strife comes about, because you're looking at another person and you're wanting what he has, and you have to work on yourself. The reason I've got to the position I am now, because I had to go through a lot of stuff. I had to, there was no choice. That's how you gain more wisdom, that's how you gain more knowledge, that's how you gain more understanding. Okay? And divisions, that's how division comes. And you are you not yet carnal? So you're in the flesh. These things come from the flesh. Okay? And walk as men. For while one saith, I am Paul, and another saith, I am Apollos. Alright? And he was Apollos. Okay? Given by what? Apollo. And remember, the Greeks had Greek idols. Okay? And Apollo was really the Israelite that came under what? Paul. And he was from Alexandria. And he was mighty in the scriptures. And he became what? An Israelite. He was converted. Okay? Even though he was an Israelite, but converted, I mean to the faith. Okay? But ministers by whom we believe. Even as the Lord gave to every man. So that's all they were, ministers. They didn't want to be thought of higher than they were. I have planted. Alright? Paul planted. And Apollos. Okay? Another Israelite. Okay? Watered. Okay, so that's what brothers do. Okay, One can plant but affects another to water. Metaphor to imbue, saturate one's mind. Ooh. Okay, I want to be saturating your mind with this proof, and it's for you. But the multi gave the increase, so it's your habitat ultimately that gives the increase. It's going to that one increase. Bear me just a minute.
Axano.
And when you go into that word increase of inward Christian, so-called Christian growth, Israelite growth, so it's Yahawashai that gives that increase. You can plant that seed, but the increase comes from Yahawashai. Now he that planteth and he that watereth are one, which is Yahawashai, Yahweh Yahweh, and every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. Right? One body, but it's about your labor. What do you bring to the table? What are you adding? Are you someone that's just taking away? Are you adding? You want to be those that add to the ministry, because I believe every brother's got a God-given talent. Okay? But that comes through what? Not wanting to be comfortable. The hard situations, and it makes you tough, and it makes you mentally strong. So you should strive to want that. You pray for faith. What do you think you have this going to do? It's going to put you in scenarios where it acquires faith. But if you're not in that scenario, then you've got to ask yourself, well, do you really want that experience? Do you really want to grow? Are you just comfortable in the confines of your own little space? So with this, I hope this was edifying. And until the next time, shout out to the hopeful elect. Shout out.